Students, just now we studied about the Van't Hoff factor, which gives us the mathematical expression for the ratio of colligative properties of electrolytes divided by the colligative properties of non-electrolytes of the same concentration. Now we will study about the modification of expressions for colligative properties of electrolytes. We have studied the different mathematical expressions for the relationship between different colligative properties and molar mass of the solute or the concentration of the solute for non-electrolyte solutions. But those expressions are not applicable to the colligative properties of the electrolytes. So, in those equations, we will modify those equations to get the colligative properties of electrolytes. And there are total four expressions for the colligative properties of electrolytes which are modified using the Van't Hoff factor. The first colligative property is vapor pressure lowering, and for that we know the equation delta P is equal to P01X2. But now for the colligative property of electrolyte, the equation can be modified as delta P is equal to I upon P01X2, which is equal to I into W2M1 divided by M2 into W1. The another modified expression for colligative property of electrolyte is delta TB. Delta TB is equal to I KB into M, which is equal to I KB into 1000 into W2 divided by M2 into W1. And the third equation is for freezing point depression, that is delta TF is equal to I KF into M, which is equal to I KF into 1000 into W2 divided by M2 into W1. And the next equation for colligative property of electrolyte, which is modified of the equation of the colligative property of non-electrolyte, the modified form is pi is equal to I MRT, which is equal to I W2RT divided by M2 into V. In all these equations, all the terms used, that is delta P, delta TB, delta TF, pi, KF, KB, X2, W2, M1, M2, W1, etc. All these terms have the usual meanings that we have studied in case of colligative properties of non-electrolytes. Now, one thing you must remember, that we studied about the Van't Hoff factor for electrolytes, and we saw that the Van't Hoff factor for NaCl is 2, KNO3, the Van't Hoff factor is also 2, for CaCl2 the Van't Hoff factor is 4. Similarly, these are the values of Van't Hoff factor which are applicable only to the dilute solutions. In dilute solution, the electrolyte undergoes complete dissociation. But this argument of the about Van't Hoff factor or the higher values of the colligative properties is not applicable to the concentrated solutions, because in concentrated solutions the ions which undergo dissociation, which form after the dissociation of the electrolyte, these ions form ion pairs due to higher electrostatic force of attraction between them. And so it is observed that the colligative properties of the electrolytic solutions which have the high concentration are the lower than the expected value. Because what happens in concentrated solution, the ions formed form the ion pairs because of the repulsive force of attraction between them, and they form the ions of one or more cation with the ion of one or more anion. They form ion pairs, and due to formation of these ion pairs, what happens? The number of solute particles goes on decreasing, and as the number of solute particles decreases, the colligative property observed for the electrolytic solution having high concentration is lower than the expected, and the colligative properties are higher only for the dilute solutions of the electrolytes. the next point is Van 't Hoff factor and degree of dissociation. In the preceding discussion, we studied about the colligative properties of electrolytes and Van 't Hoff factor. But all that discussion was based on the fact that the electrolyte undergoes complete dissociation, and that discussion was only applicable to the strong electrolytes. Strong electrolytes undergo complete dissociation. But those considerations are not applicable to the weak electrolytes, because the weak electrolytes do not undergo complete dissociation. Some part of the weak electrolytes remains as it is in undissociated state, though we form the solution of that weak electrolyte. Weak electrolytes apan solution tayar kela tar tyachyamadhe dissociation hota, pan te complete nasta, 100% nasta. The weak electrolytes do not undergo complete dissociation. Tyanchyatla jo kahi part ahe to undissociated rahto. Some of the part of the weak electrolytes remains in undissociated state. So for weak electrolytes, we must take into consideration or a concept that is called as degree of dissociation is alpha. And that part of alpha, what is degree of dissociation? Degree of dissociation is a mathematical quantity which gives us the actual value of the how much of the weak electrolyte is dissociated. So dissociation of weak electrolyte is related with the concept of degree of dissociation, which is denoted by letter alpha. Degree of dissociation is denoted by alpha, and the value of degree of dissociation alpha affects the Van 't Hoff factor. There is an effect of degree of dissociation on the value of Van 't Hoff factor. So we must study the relationship between Van 't Hoff factor and degree of dissociation, so that while calculating the different colligative properties of the weak electrolytes, we will be able to calculate it correctly. So we must study the relation between Van 't Hoff factor and degree of dissociation, that is the relation between I and alpha. For that, consider an electrolyte having the molecular formula AXBY. That means there are X atoms of A and Y number of atoms are B present in the electrolyte. So its molecular formula is AXBY. As AXBY is an electrolyte, it undergoes dissociation into its aqueous solution. The dissociation of the electrolyte is shown as follows. AXBY undergoes dissociation to form X number of A ions having positive charge, which is equal to Y plus. So AXBY undergoes to form XAY plus plus YBZ minus. That means after the dissociation of electrolyte AXBY, total X number of A Y plus ions are formed, and total number of BZ minus ions is equal to 1. So initially at the reaction of dissociation, the total moles of AXBY will be equal to 1 mole. That means the dissociation is just started. So the AXBY is completely in undissociated state, so total moles initially will be equal to 1 of AXBY, and the total moles of XAY plus will be 0, and the total moles of YBZ minus will be 0 at the initial point of the starting point of the dissociation. At equilibrium, consider that the alpha number of particles of the electrolyte AXBY are dissociated. So at equilibrium, the total moles of AXBY will be equal to 1 minus alpha moles. Why 1 minus alpha? Because 1 is the number of moles of electrolyte at the beginning, and out of them the alpha moles are undergone dissociation. So what remains in undissociated state is 1 minus alpha moles. Now, The alpha moles of A have under one dissociation and alpha moles of B have under one dissociation. So the total moles of X AY plus at equilibrium is equal to X alpha moles, and total moles of Y BZ minus at equilibrium will be equal to Y alpha moles. These are the number of moles of undissociated electrolyte and dissociated ions at equilibrium. Now we have to calculate the total number of moles which are present in the solution. That means it is the sum of number of moles in undissociated state and number of moles in dissociated state. So the number of moles in undissociated state is 1 minus alpha, and that of the in dissociated state is X alpha and Y alpha. So the total moles after dissociation will be equal to 1 plus alpha plus X alpha plus Y alpha. Now we will add this by taking alpha as the common factor. So what we get is 1 plus alpha into bracket X plus Y minus 1. By rearranging it, what we get is 1 plus alpha into bracket N minus 1. Here N is nothing but the sum of X and Y, that is N is equal to X plus Y, that is the moles of A and B produced after the dissociation. So what we get is total moles after dissociation is equal to 1 plus alpha into bracket N minus 1. Now this is the equation that has obtained for the total moles of different components that are dissociated and undissociated after the dissociation at equilibrium. Now we will relate this alpha part, that is the degree of dissociation, with Van 't Hoff factor. We know the equation for Van 't Hoff factor, that is I is equal to actual moles of ions produced after dissociation divided by the moles of formula units dissolved. So for I, the equation obtained is I is equal to 1 plus alpha into bracket N minus 1, and rearranging the equation, what we get is I minus 1, this one which is on the right side is taken to the left hand side, so it becomes negative. So what we get is I minus 1 is equal to alpha into bracket N minus 1. Rearranging it for alpha, what we get is alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. This is the relationship between Van 't Hoff factor and degree of dissociation, which that relation we must take into consideration for the colligative properties of weak electrolytes, because weak electrolytes do not undergo complete dissociation, they undergo partial dissociation. So the weak electrolyte colligative properties are related to the concept of degree of dissociation, which affects the value of Van 't Hoff factor, and hence this equation is essential to study, because the value of Van 't Hoff factor depends on the degree of dissociation of the weak electrolytes. We will be now solving some numericals based on the Van 't Hoff factor for the colligative properties of electrolytes. Students, in preceding discussion we studied the colligative properties of electrolytes, and we have seen the different modified forms of the expressions of colligative properties of electrolytes. In the modified forms of colligative properties, we have included a factor called as Van 't Hoff factor, which is denoted by I, and based on these modified expressions of the colligative properties of electrolytes, we will be solving the numericals. I have written a numerical, I will read it and then we will solve it. 3.4 gram of CaCl2, that is calcium chloride, is dissolved in 2.5 liter of water at 300 Kelvin. What we have to calculate is what is the osmotic pressure of the solution, and for that we have given Van 't Hoff factor for CaCl2, that is calcium chloride, is 2.47. We have read this numerical. Now before solving the numerical, we will write down the given values that I have written here. First is molar mass of the solute, that is W2. It is given as 3.4 gram. Here it is given that 3.4 gram of CaCl2 is dissolved. That means it is the mass of the solute which is dissolved in the given volume of solvent, which is W2, 3.4 gram. The next quantity that is given is the volume of solvent, water. V is equal to 2.5 liters. Next is the temperature that is given is 300 Kelvin. And the one more value that we will require is I, that is Van 't Hoff factor. It is also given, that is 2.47. In the calculating the osmotic pressure, we need one more value, that is R, gas constant. The value of R is not given in the numerical, but it is considered that you know that value. R is equal to 0.08206 decimeter cube atmosphere Kelvin inverse mole inverse. If you observe the given values carefully, you will find that while writing the value of R, it is expressed in decimeter cube and the volume is given in liters, and we cannot use the different values which are given in different units. They must be converted into same system of the units. But we know that 1 decimeter cube is equal to 1 liter. So the value of volume remains as it is in decimeter cube. So I have not written the converted value. And the remaining thing is molar mass of the solute, which is equal to 111 grams. It is not given in the numerical, but you all know that how to calculate the formula mass or molar mass of the different substances, which we have studied it in 11th standard. Using that formula, you calculate the molar mass of CaCl2, which comes out to be 111 grams. What is to be find? We have to find the osmotic pressure of the solution. So pi we have to find. The formula for that is pi is equal to I into W2RT divided by M2V. Using this formula, we will calculate the osmotic pressure of the solution. We will go to solution of the numerical. Pi is equal to, we have the formula, we will substitute all the given values into the given formula. Pi is equal to I, the value of I is 2.47 multiplied by W2 is 3.4 into R is 0.08206, which is multiplied by the temperature, that is 300, and this is divided by M2 into V. M2 is the molar mass of solute, which is 111 gram, multiplied by volume, that is 2.5 liters. You have to solve this, multiply all these values which are given in the numerator, then multiply all the values which are in the denominator, and then go for the division. So the value of pi after the completion of this calculation comes out to be 0.745. The value of osmotic pressure is 0.745. We must give the unit. See, in the value of R, the pressure, the unit of pressure is atmosphere. So for osmotic pressure of the solution, the unit will be equal to atmosphere. So after solving this numerical, the value of osmotic pressure of the solution is equal to 0.745 atmosphere. This is the numerical based on colligative properties of electrolytes, and with this numerical we have completed our topic, that is solutions. You just go through the topic in the textbook and solve the different types of numericals which are given in the exercise for your practice. Thank you.